Nonprofit Spotlight is at Pathpoint, and we'll actually be featuring a two-segment special about the work that Pathpoint does in the Santa Barbara community. Right now, we'll be speaking with Cynthia Burton, who is the CEO and director of Pathpoint. We'll also be talking with Jennifer Newbold, the vice president and director of Pathpoint's mental health division. Let's start our spotlight. Well, thank you, Cindy, so much for being with us today on Nonprofit Spotlight. Would you start off by telling our viewers the mission of Pathpoint?
Sure, Megan. Our mission is to provide comprehensive training and support services that empower people with disabilities and disadvantages to live and work as valued members of their community.
Now, we are standing in the El Carrillo building. When was Pathpoint founded, and can you tell us a little bit about this building and the other buildings that Pathpoint has?
Okay, happy to do that. Pathpoint was founded actually in 1964. Our name then was Work Training Programs. We changed it 2 years ago to better reflect what we do in today's world to Pathpoint. But back in 1964, we were founded to provide work services to people on public assistance. After about 5 years, we took what we had learned about people that had pretty significant barriers to going to work and applied it to a newly developed community-based service system for people with developmental disabilities.
Okay.
That was about 1970. And from that point, we provided both in-home living services, helping somebody live on their own, who otherwise would have been in an institution not that many years ago, especially not 1970, that
sure.
many years ago, and helping people find and keep jobs. And today, those are still the two main things that we do.
Well, we're going to be talking with Jennifer next. Mm-hmm. But before that, is there information as to any social networking, Facebook, website information that people can look for if they're interested in learning more about Pathpoint?
We have a wonderful website, www.pathpoint.org. We have a Facebook page, and I'm really excited about that because that's a new way to reach a new group of people to tell about what we do and to really encourage them to become partners with us in helping people integrate and live that full life in their community. So our Facebook page is Pathpoint. Search for it, become a fan, and there's updates. We also have on our website, and I think it on the Facebook page, a way to sign up for our monthly email contact.
Oh, fantastic.
And that gives really up-to-date information about what's going on at Pathpoint.
Well, thank you so much, Cindy, for talking with us. And next, we'll be talking with Jennifer. Well, thank you, Jennifer, for joining us today. Would you start off by telling our viewers about the mental health division of Pathpoint?
Right. As Cindy told you, the mental health division started in 1980, and we delivered day program services and residential services.
Okay.
But since that time, we've expanded our services to also address the needs of homeless people and people who have substance abuse disorders.
And how many people are served by the mental health division?
Last year, we served over 300 people in both of our programs.
And as I talked with Cindy about this El Carrillo building,
right.
can you tell me more about what sorts of programs happen here? Who comes here? What exactly is the El Carrillo project?
El Carrillo was founded in 2006 as part of the 10-year plan to end homelessness. And so everybody that lives here has either a mental health diagnosis or a substance abuse problem. And so our services are really meant to help create a community of recovery. And when I talk about recovery, I think of recovery from addiction, reunification with family members, that those relationships may have been fractured, recovery from mental illness, getting proper treatment for those illnesses. So we have group, we have individual, we have volunteer opportunities at a garden here in town.
Oh, fantastic.
Anything to get people to have meaningful activity and break that cycle of homelessness.
How does someone go about coming to Pathpoint, and how do they go about finding a home here at El Carrillo?
Well, you know, when El Carrillo opened, we had a waiting list of over 200 people.
I would imagine.
There was so much need, so we still have a waiting list. The application process is through the Housing Authority here in the city of Santa Barbara.
Okay.
And we can help people apply for those apartments. Unfortunately, there's a need in the community for more housing of this sort with services to help people address their problems rather than just find housing. But how do you end homelessness if you don't have a home?
Exactly. Is there help offered by Pathpoint outside of El Carrillo? And if so, can you explain to our viewers what
Absolutely.
That is?
Absolutely. We have, in 2006, we started a new program. It's called Paths to Recovery, and that is innovative in that it follows an evidence-based practice of supported housing, meaning it's been found to be effective in the treatment of mental health issues.
Okay.
That team of staff is a multidisciplinary staff that includes a psychiatrist, nursing staff, mental health clinicians, substance abuse disorder treatment folks, culturally competent bilingual staff.
Okay. Wow.
And so that team of people go out into the community. We go to hotels, family homes, other providers, other apartment complexes, so we disperse in the community and provide individualized treatment and support so that people can avoid eviction. And really the idea is to avoid going to the emergency room or utilizing high-cost emergency services.
What sort of success stories can you tell me about through that have come out of the program?
You know, the idea of El Carrillo was to give people a leg up, to come here to address their problems and then to move on to apartments where they can have larger cooking facilities, get a car, go back to school, get a job. And so the success that we've had here is about people finding jobs, about qualifying for housing alternatives away from El Carrillo, and beginning to have more meaningful, fulfilling lives. So there are people that are you could speak to on the property who mm-hmm. can speak to that goal and them achieving their purpose in life.
Well, thank you so much, Jennifer, for sharing with our viewers all the work that Pathpoint's Mental Health Division is doing. Really appreciate it.
Thank you.
You're watching Nonprofit Spotlight.
If you'd like your nonprofit featured in a future Nonprofit Spotlight, contact us at the information on your screen.